We need to go now. Being called in the middle of the night for an emergency and having to like get up and run and get out on the boat and focus really hard.
Once you've seen it and you've been here and you're involved, it's very difficult to turn your eyes away from the situation.
Go that way! All the way that way!
Go down that side, okay? Thank you, thank you. Okay, madam. It's okay, you're safe. Come with me. It's okay, you're safe. Come and sit down here next to your friend, okay?
I made this decision to go to university after several years of doing a lot of different humanitarian work, and I decided I wanted to really find a skill that was a speciality, something that I could go and use and make a difference somewhere. Coming back and joining normal daily life was like harder than being there on the job itself. It really hit me, you know, like I really started to see that the people around me have no idea, absolutely no idea, what's happening right here on our doorstep in Europe. And it frustrated me, it made me sad, it made me want to talk about it and share with people what had happened. I faced a lot of negativity towards it sometimes. And, you know, for me it was so obvious that rescuing these people was the right thing to do and what had to be done.
Salam.
And it's very difficult for people to understand that when they just read the news and see the statistics. They don't understand why they're fleeing. They haven't spoken to them. They haven't made that connection. They haven't seen them cry with happiness that they've been saved. And I think that telling the truth about this situation through the media is so, so important. You see so many lies all the time and so many manipulations of the truth. That ultimately has a massive role to play in people's opinions, and people's opinions ultimately in this political environment that we're living in is what is fueling this rise in right-wing governments and fascism. It's all about power and the political game, which ultimately has hindered the work that we do here. There were so many times that we were stopped and we were challenged and our operations were denied by the government or the officials. We'd been criminalized for something which is not criminal, you know? Surely it's a massive help and we're doing the jobs that they would have to do if we weren't there. And the other side of it, the witnessing and the talking about what we're seeing here, is an act of political resistance, I believe. For me, the life that I want to live is something that fulfills me. If I want to feel that I've done something with my life, that I've taken my privilege and I've given a little piece of that to somebody that is a little bit less fortunate than myself. That's what makes me feel good.